Okay, I'll put this bit of video in at the front of the video and at the back, just for a bit of contrast really. So at the start of the video you can see how it was finished and compare that to the first few clips. This work was done in a few sections. This is the first section, then I did this part, and then what we'll call the main nut here of the work, and this bit at the back here. So this section was done. What happened here was I built a framework and I pushed the cement in along here after scraping out the loose dirt and stone. What happened was it got very hot just as I mixed up, and it became hotter for me because I was working, and I did suffer some body and brain damage. A year and a half later I did this section here. I did this section in winter and I used lime, so with lime it won't slump, and I was able to do this section, this main section here. I had a most of the work was done, and then this part was smoothed off. So that just says that when it was built, 1974, then there was a bathroom renovation in 1988, and then a house renovation between 2008 and 2015 with follow-up work, but that's it. That's how she was all fixed up. Now this stone wall here has a good foundation to rest on, and should be problem-free. So now I'll turn you over to the start of the video, and if you are at the end of the video, then that's a take.
Okay, what happened with this video is a year and a half ago, I recorded this. It was very, very hot, and on this day I overheated, and I suffered some internal and maybe brain damage temporarily. It was too hot to work. I should have done a smaller section. However, here I'm explaining that the stone wall there, the stone bricks, is resting on fairly good foundation. However, there is a course of loose rubble in between that. So in the past, that section there did crack. And what I did was I dug way down on top, you can't see it, but on top of the landing there, and poured cement into it. So that's now secure. You can see that in the past, around about in the 1970s, they put that sandstone there. They formed those sandstone bricks and built a wall. If you fast forward 10 minutes, you'll come to the sound. But what happened here is the sound didn't turn out, and so I'm sitting here now just explaining. I don't throw out video, so it's just kept as so you can see here, the right at the bottom there's a good foundation stone, fairly good foundation stones above it, but through the middle there there's a course of loose rubble, and you can see roots growing through it, and that won't hold the stonework above it. And that's a fairly important wall there, because it's the entire side path up around to the back door. But that big boulder there I'm keeping, and at this point in time the work's not finished, but that big boulder there at the very, in this shot at the front of it, I'm keeping that. That's a good foundation. However, in front of that there's stones that I'll have to remove, so that's a back away from the angle, the edge. That's working forward, and there you can see that loose course of stone there. And there's a good rock above it, supporting it. There's a lot of weight up there, you know. So I have to do something about this now, and I'm part of the way through at this point in time. But that small rock in front there, in front of the crack, that's got to be removed, and anything there that you see there to the right hand side. So at the moment, that big rock there that I'm pointing at behind that crack there, that one there, that's supported at this point in time. So I think I've said most of it, but what I will say is that using lime in the sand and cement is the key to this sort of work. You can't just mix up sand and cement, because it will slump. Okay, it'll fall down. And I think that lime's got a fairly good ability to prevent water absorption, and it has a strengthening effect. As much as it's got good plasticity with the lime in it. So that is to say, you know, if you form a hill, say, like pottery, with lime in the sand and cement, it'll stay there. It won't just slump. So what I've done here is, with a jackhammer, I've just removed that loose rubble through there, and I've gone in about 100 millimeters, and I'm filling that with sand and cement. I'm getting better as I go, and using the lime has been a really good move. So I think here I'm just saying that I'll do it in sections. That's a good idea. However, the first section where I actually build a plaster sheet support mold, where I can sort of get my fingers in above it, it didn't work out too well. There was no need for it. I should have just mixed lime in with the sand and cement. But I'm just pointing out here that shot back there, that's a small creeper, and I did say that I'd probably have to remove that, and that was removed yesterday, so that now there's no roots. I mean, there'll be roots from that tree probably mulling around and growing around there, but you want to, you know, when it comes to trees and that type of thing, they will destroy things like cement slabs and foundation rock, such as we're seeing here. That's work that I've done in the past. There is a video on that, and I've just put sand and cement, like a ledge, a flat level ledge on it, to protect the stone underneath from weathering away, and also to make a workable flat surface that you can work on. Okay, so here it looks like I've removed some rubble. I've gone in a little bit. Probably first attempts, you know, when you come in to start a job, you usually, unless you're a professional and that's your line of work, you usually work to extremities, like your tools and system and design may be insufficient, and so you go with bigger, more powerful tools and you're able to get it done. But you start off small and work to big. Yeah, so there is some cracking there. It's probably like that before they put the path around to the back of the house. The sand and cement in that stone wall isn't really strong enough. They didn't put enough cement in with the sand. Yeah, so here it looks like I've probably done a bit more work. That's a little bit of earth coming through. In between the rock surfaces there, there's earth movement. You know, up around Sydney, there's a lot of sandstone rock on top of bedrock. So if you look at a hill that's been excavated or mined, There's a large amount of pure sandstone, and then you've got like rocks, and then earth and rocks and stones. And the stones become smaller as you get up to the top of the on top of the soil or stone. So further down you go here, the less earth and the more pure sandstone. So there it looks like I had the jackhammer out. There was a quick shot of that. And here it's probably the work's done, the initial work to expose, to get rid of the rubble and earth and expose a surface I can work with and fill it in with cement just to support that rock above. I mean, we don't know how far that rock comes out. It could go back a long way, but I don't think so. I think that's the original stone face, and then they've put in, they've got rid of anything forward of that because there's a garage behind us. So here we are, and that's just about ready for sand and cement. You see there are different courses, different layers, with earth in between, but the rocks slowly move along. So this is where I went wrong. See, not having used lime recently, or not having used it, I was thinking about getting lime, but I thought I'd just go with the materials I had. I wanted to make a good start on that day. And what happened on this day was, as I mixed up sand and cement, as I say later on in the video, the temperature shot up about 15 degrees and I just got hammered. In the middle of working with materials that were curing and going hard, so it's just bad luck. I could have looked at the weather forecast, but that's not really reliable. So, however,
okay, well, it's nearly 4 o'clock, and it was extremely hot during the middle of the day. And I was able to rest, but only after mixing up quite a substantial amount, quite a lot of cement. I've got a feeling that a lot of it's probably fallen down behind the plaster sheet barrier there. The last video didn't work out. I think that was a video of me putting the cement in to fill the hole. So, well, anyway, we'll carry on and can see here, looks like a fair amount has fallen down. So it's time to take away the plaster sheet and see what I've got, so I'll do that now. At this stage, I'd just like to say that in a situation like this, you do have to be careful that as it goes hard, that you're pushing the cement up and in to fill the hole. Sometimes if you get something and press hard against it, it'll give, and there'll be a hole there somewhere if you haven't worked it up underneath into the gap. Okay, well, first impressions is it's not too bad, so let's see. Thank you. Okay, that work was, and I've still got one section, two sections, so from there to there was 1.5 bags of cement and 4.5 bags of sand. Okay, so here we are 1.5 years later, or to be precise, 1.5 months later. I don't know what I'm going to do with the first video shot nearly 1.5 years ago. So I'll get to that, and that'll be on the front of the video, and this will be behind. So yeah, what I would have said was virtually all this and this course of stone here is sitting on this good bedrock stone base, however with loose rubble. So this was all sitting on loose rubble really, and what we're doing is just shoring up that, because there was a crack here that was fixed about 3 or 4 or 5 years ago, but now we have to support this stone, remove these two stones here, and get rid of the loose rubble that this is sliding on, and do the same as what's done there underneath here, and just retain all of this, support it all. As I probably already stated, it was a really weird day when I did this work. It was extremely hot. That is to say that it was fine. I set everything up, and as soon as I mixed up the cement and started doing the work, it shot up about 15 degrees Celsius, and I actually had body damage or internal organ damage, or just effects from the heat, as well as my brain, I think. That's actually not a joke, so it's taken me a fair amount of time, or I should say that I thought it'd be a good idea to do this in winter, and we're in the middle of winter now, so I'll give it another shot. Also, as I probably already stated or said, that I did lose the audio on the video now, the first clips of the video. I don't know what's going on there. That's also very weird, just like it's weird that the temperature went up so high as soon as I started doing the work. Anyway, it's just now filling in there. I've got about 70% confidence in this work here. When I keyed it out, it did go back to a rock base. There was only really the rubble at the front. This is fairly strong cement. One possible thing, I could have already have stated this in the start of the video, but one thing I could possibly have done is mixed up a dry mix and packed it in and brushed it off. Now I'm pretty sure that with this cement, and that's another strange thing about this video, is all of the shots of the mixing up of the cement didn't work either, so I've got no idea. This is a very strange video, and it's going to be sort of pieced together. So yeah, all of the mixing up in the burrow out there of the cement, that's just lost, or it's in another universe. I don't know, but anyway, when I mixed this up, I did use the cement, and you can see these chips of where the cement had maybe been long life affected or moisture affected. So anyway, getting back to the point, it's just finishing off that, removing any rubble. I've got to do this in three stages. I've got to first do this area and support that. Then I have to remove this stone here and support that, and then just get rid of that last the last area against the wall. This here is from work done, as I've said, a long time ago. That was done with, I think, river wash sand or something. That's very hard cement, but that's keeping everything else together. But I won't make this video any longer than it already is going to be, so on with the work. Thank you. Yeah, that's right, you're seeing correct. Now it's raining. So last time it wanted to bake me, and now it wants to electrocute me. See here just how loose it is. Okay, for that one you need ear hearing protection, your gloves, and eye protection. Okay, so there we have it. Okay, and there's a ridge going downward there, and that's so that when the cement's put in, that it's got like a bond and a key and it can't work its way out. Okay, so that's the top of the stone there. And the light on this camera is now working for the first time, so if there's a bit of extra light there, that's why. I mean, it hasn't worked in about 2 years, but now decides to work. Okay, so there we have it. That's the existing, from the previous, or the start of the video, a year and a half ago. So, this bit of, there's a video about this one. Just this piece of cement came off. That's okay. You can fill that in. Okay, that's it for today. Anyone who watched the unit mold, problem where I painted the unit with oil-based paint with mold killer in it. Just in addition to that, I think the video is called something like Unit Mold and Other Observations or something like that. Anyway, it's recently, if you look for the video around about this time span that this video was released. Anyway, to cut a long story short, I did find this rotting piece of wood, and I have cleared away behind here. There were roots and a fair amount of dirt as well. So yeah, that's an addition to this video. Okay, so that channel along there, that's all cleaned up. So just quickly on that one, there was mould growing sort of along the bottom portion of the unit there, and just around the corner. So yeah, it pays to keep it all clear. And they say, I've watched a video and they do say that to stop mould, you've got to stop the dampness source. That's the amount of dampness, roots and growth that I removed. Okay, so there we are, and I've washed that out with water. You can see here with this piece of stone here is how mushy it is, and we've got all this huge wall sitting on it. Okay, this is what I'm thinking. This is how I'll do it this year. What I'll do is I'll mix up, and then I'll get my gloves and I'll smear it along the top and the bottom and all around, so that it gets a good key, good grip on, especially the top. So I don't want any gap around the top that later on can settle. And then I'll put this back. I've got the retaining wall there, and these pieces of wood coming off the garage, all packed out, and might put some plastic drop sheets down there, just so that it doesn't fall down. And then I'll fill this up with cement and try and, you know, work it back in on top under there. This time, or this year, I've got this hydrated lime, and what that does is it gives it plasticity, so it won't all sort of slump and fall down, be like a lump that will stay together. So that's the directions, information. Okay, so I'll just go a bit closer on that. Don't really see people working with lime all that often. So I'll just take a bit of time to record this. Don't get it on your skin, don't breathe it in. So okay, this is the cement I'm using. And this the sand I'm using is it's actually grey whitewashed sand these days, but you know, who really cares? You know, that's a dark colour. That's the strongest stuff I can get. Okay, well, I'll make a start. Okay, so expect the unexpected, and you know, there's going to be a lot of mess. And you know, spillage and tracks from my feet. So, you know, you don't want that left after the work. So, I'm just covering all my surfaces. We've got the technical people out today. So, you know, if there's other work going on in the background, then that's what that's all about. Got no internet here. Haven't had internet for about 4 days, 4 or 5 days. So, don't know what that is. All the computer system's good in the house, but apparently it's somewhere in the line. So apparently the problem is 100 meters away, and that's the same place that the previous problem was. So I think that's out on the street, and yeah, that's kind of weird, you know. 100 meters is like out the driveway, up the hill and around. I don't know if the other people have internet or not here, but anyway, you know, it breaks, we fix it. An interesting piece of stone there. You always get a whole lot of sandstone and then old growth area, sandstone growth. You know, you see it when they excavate. It just makes you wonder about the history of the world. You know, what's been happening, you know, is there growth like this and then a whole lot of sand comes, or what? Anyway, so getting back to it, I'll mix up now, and if I need to, I'll put this on to support the cement. If not, I'll just leave it out. Okay, well, it's 12 o'clock. It's the middle of winter. I've only got about 4.5 hours of daylight left. So, unfortunately, the shopping this morning and setting up and everything taken longer than I thought. So, I'll carry on tomorrow. There is scattered showers forecast for tomorrow, but I can pin up a drop sheet and let it cover the work. So that's how I'll deal with it. Just hope it's no rain. Okay, it's 20th of the 6th, 2020. So, in other words, right smack dab in the middle of the COVID-19 thing. Today what I'm going to do is I'm just going to retain this stone here. And I've got a couple of bricks. When I mix up the mortar, and I'll find out what ratios I need, and I'm using lime, by the way, as well. And the next video over here, I'll show you the ratios I'm using. So that's what it is at the moment, and I'll get to it. Okay, I'm pretty happy about this work. Key points are that the cement was keyed up underneath and worked around so that it bonded first. If I could do this little section of work again, I would get a spray bottle or a sponge and wet the area first, just so that the cement bonded even easier. Not to the point where it would slump, but just put a coating of water on it first. But you know, this is roughed up, and that means that I can finish the outside first, I mean later on. So that's the ratio I used. And then if I thought that it was a little bit too wet, I balanced it up with cement. I added cement to get it drier. However, I have noticed before and this time as well, that when you mix up cement, you mix it up, it seems dry, and then it becomes wet. But then with say 5 minutes, it becomes drier again to that first consistency that you mix it up with. So there's that to bear in mind. Okay, so that's it for this weekend. That's all I can do and want to do. So I've got my ratios right, and next weekend I come along with the jackhammer. I remove this stone here. possibly all of it, maybe, or the other stonework here, this loose stone, sandstone, and this one here. What I might do is go straight down, remove, say, this section here, and maybe, you know, key it up, build a framework around it, and pour it right up to, say, the top, and then sort of come out on a block. So I have a top block ledge here, but for that I've got to have a fair amount more, possibly, of materials, but we'll see. Okay, over and out for this weekend. But just before I do wrap up for this weekend, it's amazing how much materials you need. All of this is in case I need to put the framework here on the against the cement. And yeah, it's just amazing. It amazes me time and time again just how much materials you need. That's nothing, that's just pots, but and all this has to be packed up, and that's part of the 30-40% added cost you need to why you need to add that amount onto the cost of a quote and all that sort of thing. It's just, yeah, quite outstanding. Okay, Sunday 5th of July 2020, and I've had to get my forklift license, and so there's the lessons during the week and study on the weekends. I'm training to transport chip pellets, transport pellets, the blue ones. So there's loading on and off the truck, the semi, and a lot of very complicated paperwork to learn. So that's why it's a couple of weeks later. Last time in the video, there was a van here, and they were fixing the internet line. And what happened there was we had internet for 2 hours, and then we lost it. So they fixed it, they took off, and then we lost internet. But we got it again. Do you remember? Yeah, so you might remember I was talking about salting. And this is what I mean. That there. That's cement under concrete, under cement. So it could be the concrete that's causing the salting. You can also see it along there. But this looks okay. So that's nice and rough, and I can put a top coat over that. So now it's just getting the jackhammer, and as I said before, just removing this stone here, anything loose up to about here, and then next weekend or whenever, mixing up and forming a retaining block there. You can see here there's this area of dirt here, and you know, that's what it's sliding on at the moment. It's pretty dry, it hasn't rained for a couple of weeks, but you know, and also this piece of stone here, that's also got an area of dirt there. When things get wet and moist, you know, it very slowly moves, and this has got no support. Okay, so you can see here that you know, that's a pretty good design. That's looking directly down on it, and we can see that the cement will sort of go out that way and in that way. So that's a good retainer. I've got a lock-in type design here where the cement will go over that ridge and won't be able to move. And this is good, you know. Got a good slant here, so that'll rest on the cement. And this goes right up and around. And all this will rest on the cement. So that's about all I'm going to do today. So I'll get the pressure washer and remove all this loose dirt and just gouge away in there with a pick and remove that dirt, and they'll provide a bit of a lock-in key. You know, I'll push cement up under there. So so that's it for today. Okay, well that's it for this weekend. I've been working here for about 3 hours. I cleaned it all out and used a high pressure cleaner, but then there was loose stone in there, so I was swapping between the hose and the jackhammer and the high pressure water cleaner. And so yeah, we can see that loose sandstone has been removed. There's a lot more out of this area here, and I was just swapping between the jackhammer to do the major work and the crowbar, the high pressure water cleaner to clean it out every time, and just found that the hose was best to get rid of the silt out of that area there. Okay, 25th of the 7th 2020. Okay, so this weekend all I have to do is just remove anything that is loose. So for instance, this corner bit here, I can see a crack going through here, so I'll drop this out, and I might get the brush and just make sure that this loose stuff is removed as much as possible. I think it's just sediment from the dirt. You can see here, interestingly enough, that this section that runs back here is actually a separate piece of rock. There's actually a crack right through there, so that's probably the stable one, and this is a moving one. Then what I'll do is use an industrial vacuum cleaner and just get a wire brush, anything loose, just get that out of there. And then I have to build a wall. So probably be a piece of flooring with this section cut out of it, so that it runs parallel across there. I can imagine just packing this out with something. There'll be a gap here, small gap, and just have it running on an angle up here and along the ground, so I can mix up and just fill in this area here. It'll take a fair amount of sand and cement and lime, but I might do some extra shopping. Have everything on hand. I don't want to do it this weekend. I want to start on a Saturday morning, so I've got Sunday if things go wrong. I can't imagine things going wrong, but I've been wrong before, and with this project, as we know from the start of this video. So I'll get that work done. I can imagine propping up the board with runners or pine wall framing going across here to the garage wall. So I'll show you what the design is in the next clip. Well, one thing I find that up in here there's like an endless gap there of fairly good topsoil, so
that goes back a fair way, and I've dug it out from around about here back. But you know, no wonder this wall was moving, because we've got this separate rock here, we've got a moving cornerstone here that's now secured, but also this big pile of dirt and these slippery areas here. So anyway, on with the job. So yeah, that's another look at the cornerstone there, and it's just pure luck, you know. Thank God that's there, that's all I can say. So yeah, there's the cornerstone there. This is the separate piece of rock here, and that's the dirt trap up inside there. So I don't think I can do this in one go. It's just too much now, because as you mix sand and cement, it collapses into a smaller form. So I'd say two or three goes. So the first one up to that level, and then I've got to pack up underneath there for a third go, and then second go, sorry, and then probably shape it up and along the side. But you can see why it would have cracked, because this cornerstone here is laying on a sliding surface, and as that moved, it took out this, and then I had to fill up, dig down on the other side there and fill all this in. I have to go up to get some something to use to contain the cement on this side here. So I'll just give you an idea of how important that that rock wall is at supporting all of this vital walkway here. So yeah, the work's got to be done. Okay, 1st of August 2020, and I think I'll make a start. I was a bit worried about the amount of earth up under here, but that seems to be all good, and I've got a good area of support there that I can build up to for the stone wall. So it's just a matter of getting this water out. Interestingly, there's seepage coming down here, so we can see water running along here, and that'd be what caused the movement of the rocks. So yeah, that's what's going on. It's coming from the back there, from the earth, and seeping down there. But anyways, it's very, very cold, so I'm certainly not going to overheat today. But ideally I should provide a drain for that, because the water from there is actually what's filled up all of this here, and you know, that's just going to back up, so that'll create an area of moisture barrier behind this wall, which won't be good. It has been raining recently, but that's sort of like a new find. I've only just noticed that. So that's that rock base there, and that's what this has been sliding on. So that's the reason for this work behind there. This isn't damp, but that's a bit of a concern. Okay, an update on this wall. So coming off a good solid slab foundation there, I've got four good supports going onto this framework here. I've got a pipe going in, and that rests right up on the dirt there. So that's that dirt coming down from here. Any moisture is hitting this rock, so it could be coming from up the way up the hill there, and just this is a gradual course of constant seepage, and that's up against the dirt there, and that's where it's going to build up and need to come out. So then that's just going to come out there, so that's going to go through all the work and provide drainage
otherwise it's going to be back up behind here, and that won't be good. That's no doubt the actual problem all along, and it's taken all this time for it to expose itself. In fact, here we can even see an area here of dampness, so that's fairly dry. And then we've got this build up here, that's the barrier, that's the border there. So this rock's been trying to hang on and support this wall. Okay, some last minute inclusions. I've got plastic packed down there. That's just a plastic bag, but I didn't need much. There wasn't too much of a space there. It was too thin for a t-shirt to pack up, or pack out, I mean. Up the end there, I've got a little plastic cap sitting over a gap there that the cement could fall into. So, let's try and get some light. Yeah, there we go. Try and focus it a bit. So that's sitting right out the end there, so no cement will drop down. Okay, the ratio we're using for this, we need a good strong mix, is one of cement, where are we? One of lime and two of sand. Okay, so it's that's the consistency I've got. I'm using Ho because in my experience it's better than anything else, any other thing you can use. So that's the consistency there. And I'm just mixing it through. I mixed it all up first as a powder form. Then I got a hose and sprayed water on it. Then I sprayed water on where it was more dry until I've got the same consistency throughout. So you can hold it like that. It won't drop. Okay. Okay, so I've got a water bottle. Just going to wet the surface, and I intend to use that as kind of like a bond. Okay, so the first one's two of sand, then I'll put one of cement. So sand, cement, two of sand, one cement, and one of lime. So this is the ratio I'm using. Got to get in another bag of sand. Okay. Now one of cement. one of lime. Oh, by the way, the sand is whitewashed. That's black whitewashed sand. Oh, by the way, never breathe any of these products in. Wet sand isn't so bad, but especially not the hydrated lime. I'm using Australian Builders cement, type GB, and Australian Builders lime as well. I get them from Bunnings. Okay, so I'm just mixing it up first. Okay, now I'll just wet it. I'll keep doing that for a while. Okay. Okay, so similar type of mix as the last mix. So the reason you want it the same consistency, same amount of lime, cement and sand, is for strength, and so that the two layers, if one dries, you'll have less chance of cracking. Okay, I've just got to worry about keeping the pipe in place so that it doesn't fall forward and expose the gap up the back or slide this way. So, same process. Okay, it is what it is now. Eventually it's going to go around it and meet this edge here. Eventually. Okay. hard yucca. Okay, well, it's starting to get late. However, I think it's time to remove the board and see what I've got. That was 4.5 wheelbarrow mixes for the cement. Okay. Okay, first impressions is that it's a success. We've got our pipe coming out here. So I removed the plastic, shaped the side up to the same edges as the rock. I'll create a bit of a slope here. That'll have to be filled in on the top a little later on. It's, the cement sets in a bit just along there. So I'll get to it. Okay, success. Like the old tradesman used to tell me back in the 80s, early 80s, when I was just starting out as a tradesman, don't play with it too much. So I'll leave it at that, over and out for today. I'll just add that I have wiped down all surfaces, and I've also shaped as best I can the cast, you could say, into the existing rock form. Okay, I'll put this bit of video in at the front of the video and at the back, just for a bit of contrast really. So at the start of the video you can see how it was finished and compare that to the first few clips. This work was done in a few sections. This is the first section, then I did this part, and then what we'll call the main nut here of the work, and this bit at the back here. So this section was done. What happened here was I built a framework and I pushed the cement in along here after scraping out the loose dirt and stone. What happened was it got very hot just as I mixed up, and it became hotter for me because I was working, and I did suffer some body and brain damage. A year and a half later, I did this section here. I did this section in winter, and I used lime, so with lime it won't slump, and I was able to do this section, this main section here. I had a most of the work was done, and then this part was smoothed off. So that just says that when it was built, 1974, then there was a bathroom renovation in 1988, and then a house renovation between 2008 and 2015 with follow-up work, but that's it. That's how she was all fixed up. Now this stone wall here has a good foundation to rest on, and should be problem-free. So now I'll turn you over to the start of the video, and if you are at the end of the video, then